Don't forget to check out and grab your copy of our two newly released books, Football, A Love Story, and What Did Football Teach Me? These books feature over 100 stories from current and former coaches, players, executives, and entertainers from across the football landscape, describing what got them involved in the game, what they love about it, and what life lessons the game taught them. You can find your copy or order your copy from our website at footballgameplan.com/books. Welcome to footballgameplan.com, where football makes sense. I'm Emory Hunt, the czar of the playbook here at Giants training camp. It's day 10 for a special four downs with the czar segment, starting with first down. Now, here's the thing. A lot of times you have trash talk all across the field. O-line trash talks, defensive line, running backs trash talks, linebackers, so on and so forth. But there's no better trash talk in between a wide receiver and a defensive back. So for first down here on four downs with the czar, let's take a look at the one-on-ones today between the wide receivers and defensive backs. Looking at second down, you want to see how well the Giants passing game and their pass defense operates in live speed and full speed. So we're just going to jump right into 7-on-7 period. Remember, that's receivers and linebackers and defensive backs, quarterbacks, tight ends, running backs. All the skill players are out there going up against each other. Very spirited practice today in 7-on-7. So here's second down, 7-on-7, offense versus defense. And now we move on to third down. We're going to get the entire team involved with Team No Huddle and Team Regular.
We'll be right back.
And finally, for fourth down, it's going to be fitting that we go to situational football. The offense is down 8 with 1:40 left and 3 timeouts going up against the defense. Let's see who gets the stop. And just some quick notes from today's practice, the Giants' second level defense, that linebacking core looks extremely athletic. Doesn't matter if it's the first team group or the third team group, each one of these guys has the ability to not only get pressure on the quarterback, but stop the run, and most importantly in this day and age in football, cover. So I think you're going to see a lot of production coming from that second level of this Giants linebacking group. This may be the most athletic group of linebackers they've had in quite some time. Next, you look at Eli Manning's ability in a two-minute no-huddle offense. I think this is one area of his game where he excels extremely. There's not been a day I've been here where he hasn't had a great day in the no-huddle hurry-up type of, portion of the practice. So once again, today he was excellent. Two-minute offense, moved the football up and down the field on the defense, did a great job just getting the football out of his hands accurately and decisively to the receiving targets. And once again, the run defense shines for the Giants. This will be the biggest surprise for many this season because of how well they can stop the run. Again, it's two sides of this coin. Maybe the offensive line can't get guys off the ball, or maybe their run defense is just that good. But that defensive line with the rotation of guys that they have up front have done an excellent job all camp long. And finally, you can't undersell how important Dwayne Harris is to this football team. Just watching him return kicks in specialty period, you see how smooth he is on those kickoff returns. As a third receiver inside in the slot, he has value once he gets the football in his hands because it's broken field running. So again, Dwayne Harris will once again play a huge role on this Giants football team. Also here in quick notes, you look at a couple of standouts. Offensively, Larry Donnell, the tight end, did a great job once again making spectacular catches in 7-on-7. Also in team drills, I think he's having an outstanding camp. And on the defensive side, Ishaq Williams, the rookie from Notre Dame, has done a great job looking even more athletic than what we saw of him at Notre Dame, doing a great job in his drops and pass coverage, also versus the run. So I think Ishaq Williams on the defense and Larry Donnell on the offense are having outstanding camps. So let's take a look at some of the sights, some of the sounds, and some of the interviews from today's practice. Thank you.
How excited are you for your first game?
Pretty excited. I mean, we've been banging around with each other for a little while. It's gonna be fun to start hitting somebody else and playing against other guys, playing against other DBs.
What are your expectations?
I expect it to be similar to practice. Physical, fast. We got a good defense and they give us good looks, so I expect the same thing.
Sterling, you got a chance to go up against another pretty highly regarded rookie, Eli Apple, in practice today. What was that like for you?
I go against him all the time, so. But iron sharpens iron. We're both getting better. Just trying to learn the schemes, and he's trying to learn the schemes, and I'm trying to learn the plays, so doing the same thing.
What makes him difficult to go against?
Like I said before, just his length. It's really strong, got good feet. So it's kind of hard in the red zone, especially when you don't have much space, especially dealing with a guy like that, just ranging.
Are you interested to see how your success on the practice field translates over to a game?
Yeah, I mean, it's just like the saying, I mean, you practice like you play. I try to give it 100% effort at practice at all times, because it truly does show up in the game. So, I expect that.
Good.
When did this little tight groin happen? Is that something that happened during practice before?
It happened during practice, but just a little tightness. I didn't want to push it and potentially make it worse. So I just told the training staff.
Sorry?
No. Just I kind of get one every camp, but it's just whether I play through it or just times up on an off day the next day or something like that. But it's just a little tightness. Just getting the treatment room, ice it up, and we'll be alright.
How long did you take it through?
A couple days or so. So we'll see.
Does that complicate things for Friday night?
I'm sure. I hadn't spoken to anybody, whether it be coach or training staff or anybody, about Friday night. But I'm sure it clouds it up a little bit.
And is that frustrating, or how frustrating?
I'm not frustrated. I just got to make sure I'm, listening to my body, make sure I'm going about this the right way, because I don't want to, ignore something and then have another major setback.
Is this maybe a little bit of a lesson learned, maybe? Last year you've been trying to push through it?
Probably. So definitely anytime I feel something that's substantial, that's something that I don't want to push through, I'm definitely going to, let the training staff know and let people know, as opposed to trying to push through it and just, counting my time out there and wanting to make the best of it no matter what. Just being a little, just being as big as workloads last week and came back the next day and practiced and everything felt good, no pain, no ailments, nothing like that. So my body's been responding well to the, wear and tear of camp. So I'm excited about that. And I just want to keep, putting things forward. Obviously, with the game on Friday, another practice tomorrow, we'll see how I feel, come tomorrow.
So that's it for day 10 here at Giants training camp. I'm Emory Hunt, the czar of the playbook. For more of our NFL coverage and training camp coverage, visit the website footballgameplan.com/NFL.